I'm Dina. I want to tell you about my mother who does not age. Her name is Manik. You know, being a young mother is very cool because you walk down the street together and everyone looks at you and your teenage daughter and thinks, wow, those two are sisters. Such a compliment simply knocks you off your feet because who does not want to look 20 at 40? But my mom does not just want to, she can do it too. Do you want me to tell you the secret of her youth? Listen now. My mother and I moved to South Korea from Europe 7 years ago. It was when she and my father divorced. I was 12 or 13, old enough to remember my father, the tyrant. He was always unhappy with something. Every day he came home from work, tired, angry, and broke down on my mother and me. I was yelled at for every little thing. A bad grade, a somewhat dirty floor, broken dishes. Even my mother did not scold me as much as he did. My mother and I lived in a house bought by a man who technically was my father, but I never felt at ease there. My mother felt the same way. She did not say it out loud, but I could feel it. My dad, the tyrant, only grew angrier over the years. And you know, my mom was also changing. At her age, she looked like an old woman. I noticed gray hairs, wrinkles on her face, arms and neck, bags under her eyes. She was very thin and always had headache. It seemed to me that old age would come to her earlier than it should have if we continued to live like this. I began to persuade her to go away, but she did not even dare. My dad made her believe that we were nothing without him, that everything we live on belongs only to him, and that we eat with his money and sleep in his house. My mother was aging in front of my eyes. I could no longer tolerate such attitude towards myself or towards her, so I decided to run. When my dad was on a business trip, I packed our belongings myself and presented my mom with the fact of it. By then, she was almost out of her mind. I grabbed her hand and we ran out of the house. We took the train, I ordered the tickets via the internet a long time ago, and we left for another city, where we stayed for 2 days. And after that, I persuaded my mom to leave the country altogether, and I chose South Korea. Yes, I've liked this country for a long time. Its customs, its cuisine, talented people. Probably everyone knows about Korean dramas or K-pop and so on. I was sure that we would be better there. It seems that only on the plane did my mother seem to wake up. She began to feel panicky. What money are we going to live on? Where and how to work? What about my school? But thanks to my smart brain, I managed to save up some money, and also I took some money from my father's safe. Yes, he did not know that I knew the code. This money should have been enough for the first few months. After a long flight, my mother and I looked like we had all the juices squeezed from us. Leaving the airport, I just wanted to sleep and eat. We did not know Korean, so we had to talk to the taxi driver only when necessary. Somehow, we managed to explain that we needed a hotel. We rented a modest room, ordered food, and for the first time in so many years, finally relaxed. We exhaled because no one shouted or screamed that something was wrong in the house. We lay down to rest. Even this was already a pleasure in itself. That night, we slept deeply and ate unhealthy, delicious food. We allowed ourselves to rest for a couple of days and then went searching for an apartment, for rent, and for work. Mom bought a Korean phrase book. We immediately signed up for classes and went to look for work. We were very happy when we found a suitable accommodation, not at all expensive. We paid and went to get our things, but when we arrived back, the door was locked. Our key did not fit. I thought that we had the wrong address. We knocked, called the owner, and then began to shout. We did not immediately realize that we had been fooled. My mom was hysterical. From our screams, the passing policeman became interested in us. We were taken to the police station, where we explained the situation through a translator. My mom was so upset that she wanted to return home. I complained to the policeman who spoke English that we were not allowed to go home. Mr. Lee Bao listened carefully to the story, accepted our application, and then said that his shift would end in 10 minutes. He asked us to wait. My mother and I were very surprised, but left the station and went to a coffee shop. Our new friend came there not in uniform, but in ordinary jeans and a t-shirt. You could not even tell he was a police officer. We got into a conversation with him and he said that he would help us. He would find the criminal who took our last money for rent and disappeared. But while we had nowhere to live, he offered us to stay in his apartment. Mom and I got kinda scared. All sorts of thoughts crept into my head, but he immediately said that he just wanted to help. "Don't think anything bad. I just wanna help you," he said. My mother and I hesitated for a long time, but still, there was nowhere for us to go, so we agreed to go with him. It turns out that he lived not far from the police station. You could even walk on foot, so we felt a bit relieved. His place was small, but with all the amenities. He gave us a room, showed us where everything was, and asked not to be shy and eat everything we could find. I asked why he was so kind to us, but he just said that he wanted to help. And then I saw a photo of a beautiful girl and asked if he was married, and he said that this was his sister, who died at the hands of her tyrant husband. She had a husband like yours. She asked me for help, but I could not believe her, and now she's gone. And I put her husband in prison for many years. He said with teary eyes. Now we knew why he wanted to help. Maybe this way he was trying to forgive himself. So we temporarily stayed with him. My mother and I went to classes, studied the city, the language. Every evening after his shift, Bao showed us local attractions. My mother mastered cooking Korean dishes. We experimented with food all day long and we were happy. So a month passed and then a second one. Our Korean was so much better. I noticed that my mom blossomed. She became different. She looked 5 years younger. She became calmer, happier. We slept and ate well, smiled a lot, and most importantly, we felt safe. By the way, my mother took up yoga, discovered meditation, healthy dieting, jogging in the mornings. Her skin lightened, wrinkles disappeared. She cut and changed her hair. She gained a little bit of weight and it suited her face. My mother looked 20 again. She was unrecognizable. She took up sports seriously. My mom changed so much that on the streets they called us sisters. And it was not only about the external beauty. She began to feel young from the inside, which turned out to be even more important. We have forgotten the past life like it was a bad dream. She found a job, I continued my studies, and eventually we rented an apartment ourselves. Thanks to our friend Bao, we lived like that for about a year, and then my mother got a job as a fitness instructor, and sports made her more and more beautiful every day. We were in love with where we lived. The country. In addition, we always kept in touch with our best friend, the policeman. It gave us courage. So one day, Bao came home. He brought us good news. He finally caught the criminal who tricked us. He got back our money. This was great news. We decided to celebrate it at a restaurant that same evening. Everything was going very well, and then Bao said that a request for our search had arrived at the police station. My dad had been looking for us all this time. Local authorities had to react, so we had to prepare for the worst. We instantly remembered the details of our past life, especially my mom, but something changed. She was no longer afraid of him. In the end, he managed to find us. We contacted him ourselves. My mom decided it. When we met him a month later at the same restaurant we celebrated the happy occasion, Bao was waiting nearby to watch us. I saw my father and how he has changed. He has grown old, especially his eyebrows. Mom stood confidently and looked him straight in the eyes. He came up and did not say hi. He immediately sat down at the table and began to eat. We were silent for the first 10 minutes, and then he told us to pack up our things and go home. Our house is here, and you are not welcomed here, my mom said shortly. Dad went nuts hearing this. He looked at her for a long time, and then at me, asked if I wanted to go with him, but I shook my head negatively. My father put his hand up, but Bao immediately ran up wearing his uniform. You should have seen the look on my dad's face. He took a deep breath and left. This was our last meeting. Since then, life has improved even more. It turns out, this is how self-love changes life for the better. Thank you for watching this to the end. Subscribe not to miss the next stories. And press the like button if you like this.